Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron, I hope you're having a great day or night in Jesus. Really cool book by Tim LaHaye and Thomas Ice. Thomas Ice is head of the Pre-Trib Research Center. I will tell you, 20 years ago, I think most everybody, as a matter of fact, I saw a poll, it was like 86% of everybody, Christians were pre-trib. Now, most are probably not. You had the Left Behind series that was huge New York Times bestsellers, but now most everybody I know is like post-trib or even amillennial, on and so forth. And so it's pretty interesting how views of Bible prophecy have just really gone the other direction. So this is a visual guide. It's a hardback book. It's got thicker paper. And I'll just tell you, it reminds me an awful lot of Clarence Larkin. Now, I don't think they copied from Clarence Larkin. I'm not saying they did. I'm just talking about it reminds me of it. So Tim LaHaye received a doctor of ministry from Western Seminary and a literary doctorate from Liberty University. Man, he's just unbelievable. I know he started this Christian organization that was like a answer to the Council on Foreign Relations, and maybe CPAC or something. I really don't know. I'm not really into conservative politics that much. But I like conservative. I'm a conservative, but just do other stuff. So here's the contents. And again, it's thicker paper. It's real glossy paper. I don't know how much this thing costs. I think I got it on sale on Amazon. You know, on Amazon, it'll say, you know, they'll send it to you for $18.99. But then if you look underneath, it'll say like used. They'll have some from $1.89 or something. Well, I try to only get things that say very good or better. Acceptable and good, like they're falling apart a lot. World's greatest library, Satan is past, present, and future. John's revelation of the future. That's good. Revelation of the church age. So we'll just let you take a look at some of this. So, you know, let's say you're not pre-trib, but you're interested in learning the pre-trib position. This would probably be a good book because it's not like hugely technical or anything, but it is very straightforward. I just got another Thomas Ice book about the Olivet Discourse from a pre-trib perspective. I'm going to tell you, if pre-trib is right, Jesus is probably coming really quick. Even if it's not right, he's probably coming really quick. I'm one of these things, I'm just like, yeah, just live for Jesus and you'll make it. That's the big thing. I saw dispensations. Here's like the eight parts of the Battle of Armageddon. Some good stuff in here. I know a lot of people, they'll say like, well, the pre-trib started with Darby. But then, like at the Pre-Trib Research Center, they've got people like in the hundreds, 200s AD era doing pre-trib. And so I'm like, well, it didn't really start. And then, like, I'll read Jesuits started preterism, and then Jesuits started pre-trib, and everybody just sounds so convincing. So I'm just like studying the Bible. The covenant. I will say this, in talking to people, let's say post-tribbers, I ask a lot of post-tribbers a lot of different questions. I've actually got a video out on questions I ask post-tribbers, and that's not even all the questions. And I don't get really good answers. So when I'm reading Matthew 24, it seems to be written to Jews, which would be Jewish believers saved in the tribulation. But I understand the non-pre-trib deal. Here's the millennial temple. Division of land during the millennium. See, stuff like that's just good. And it's good visual to me. Like, I just got through reading in my daily Bible reading Ezekiel chapters 40-48 for I don't know how many times. I think into the many dozens of times. And I always feel like a failure when I get through because I'm just like, is this really, what is this about, you know? And I know some, maybe Dwight Pentecost says that would have been if the Jews would have accepted Jesus, that's what would have happened. A lot of people, Ryrie and all this, they say, well, that's the millennial temple. I don't know. The two phases of his one coming, so rapture passages, second coming passages. And then I had a friend of mine who's very learned. I really like talking to him. And so he went into like ridiculing the pre-trib deal. He said, no, Jesus comes back once. There's one resurrection. I said, well, you know, Matthew, what is it, chapter 27, when a lot of the Old Testament saints walked around Jerusalem. I said, well, that was a resurrection, wasn't it? Well, yeah. And I'm like, well, during the tribulation in Revelation, it talks about Revelation 14. You've got, it's plainly Jewish believers resurrected. And, you know, and finally he just said, well, look, I just want to live for God. And I understand. One world government, the resurrections and judgments of Scripture. I could see teaching this. This is over 100 pages. Like, we're on page 120. What Sister Waldron's zooming in and out of, and got more. This is put out by Harvest House. They put out a lot of good books. Lot. I don't think they like Oneness Pentecostals too much. I'm a Oneness Pentecostal, but I love them, and I use what they, you know, put out. A lot of truth. Anyhow, God's good. I think we all just want to go to heaven. The second coming of Jesus, the beast and the false prophet, the various views of the millennium, history's end. It just all seems so right to me, but maybe that's how I was raised. But I will say, Bible prophecy, I'm still learning. I study it probably daily in some sort, or real close to daily, let me just say that. There may be some days I don't do it. But real close to daily. So, Charting the End Times by Tim LaHaye, Thomas Ice, probably a really good book. And man, it seems like it's getting close. Just everything, especially the money deal, getting close. I love you. God bless. Talk with you later in Jesus' name.